Our next speaker is Jonathan.
Hi everyone. So I'm going to touch on today the power of sleep. I know it's been talked about a couple of times, so I'm going to try to not repeat some of the same points that we've gone over earlier. I do have a lot of information, so I'm going to talk kind of fast. So a bit of an outline here. I'm going to really just kind of briefly touch on the basic sleep cycles from a scientific point of view. Then we're going to talk about sleeping in a foreign environment, the effects of some lack of sleep, the value of sleep, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about Thomas Edison and the way he uses sleep. And then kind of link that to the way that you can use sleep for your MBA. And then I'll give you three tips to getting a better sleep, and we'll wrap it all up from there. So, really quickly, there's two types of sleep, and this is all measured by your brain activity. So we have what's called non-REM sleep, and that's basically you falling asleep, and then your muscle activity slowly starting to drop in stage two. And then stage three is what's really important, and that's where your brain starts to really replenish and refresh a lot of its ideas and make some bigger connections between. And then we have REM sleep. So REM stands for rapid eye movement. This is when your eyes are moving a lot in your head. And this is where you're completely paralyzed. Your brain shuts your body down for that purpose. And a lot of dreaming is actually done in that state as well. So these are pretty important moving forwards. So I already have kind of gauged aside from REM, it seems to get 8 hours. But if you can just raise your hand, who thinks they are getting less sleep now than they normally do? So this is a really interesting study, is that sleeping in a foreign environment, one half of your brain actually doesn't go into a deep sleep. So I'm not sure which, if it's the left or the right, but half of it just won't resist going into that third stage, okay? So your brain is lacking valuable replenishing skills. It's not refreshing, and that causes your performance to be a little lower than usual, which I guess we're all experiencing right now. So lack of sleep can be really detrimental to your performance. 20 hours of being awake, you are physically and cognitively impaired, just as if you were drunk. And so below 7 hours of sleep, we can actually measure in your brain some of those impairments. Don't know how it's done, but it's measurable. So the importance of a good sleep. In REM sleep, the brain kind of replays your memory sequences. So you're actually making connections and learning things. Oftentimes a musician kind of will get stuck on a piece, go to sleep, wake up the next morning, and find that they're able to do it. So this helps with fine motor skills, it helps with solving problems, and your academics as well. So a nice little quote, practice doesn't make perfect, but practice with a good night of sleep makes perfect. So Thomas Edison, I thought this was really neat. We've given him credit for creating the light bulb, whether or not that's true, I don't know. But what he used to do was sit in his office chair, and he'd put a big steel pan on the ground, right on underneath his hand, and he'd hold this heavy steel ball. And so he'd fall asleep, and as he starts to enter into that stage three sleep, lose control of his muscle activity, his hand would release the ball, and it would smash onto the ground and hit the pan, and he'd wake up and start furiously writing down his thoughts. Okay? And there's other leaders that have used sleep as a tool to help them solve problems as well. Steve Jobs and Albert Einstein and all sorts of different examples. I just thought that was neat. So, of course, sleep's going to be important for completing your MBA as we're all trying to manage our time and move through this, this program. Our academic performance is going to depend deeply on the amount of sleep that we're getting. Sleep is the greatest legal performance enhancing drug that most people are probably neglecting. Okay, so athletes are starting to find that bigger sleeps are extremely helpful in their performance. So, three quick tips on how you can get a better sleep, and they're a little bit odd, but one is, of course, develop a sleep routine. So studies have found that regular sleep, going to bed at the same time every day, I know it's difficult, but that is going to deeply help the amount of deep sleep that you do get. So midnight is actually supposed to be the middle of the night, so it's not time to start working on your paper. And obviously aim for 8 hours of sleep. I know that's tough for most people. So another part is sleep in the dark. So apparently dark is destroying our ability to get a really good sleep. And 1 hour of iPhone or screen use before bed is going to delay the amount of melatonin production in your brain for 3 hours, which is going to limit the amount of stage three that important sleep that you're going to get. So a tip here is to turn off most of the lights in your house about 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed and just get used to that darkness. And then lastly is regulate your temperature. So your brain actually needs to drop about 2 to 3 degrees in order for you to fall asleep. So studies show that sleeping naked will help you. And Dr. Matthew Walker recommends wearing gloves and socks. So I know that might look a little odd if you get out of the bathroom, but it'll help you regulate your temperature, it'll help you fall asleep, and in turn it'll help you get a deeper and better sleep. So yeah, in this book that I was recently reading, it was an interesting quote. He said, sleep is not like a bank, so we can't accumulate a debt and try to repay it later. So although power naps or taking naps might help you feel a lot less tired and refresh yourself for the day, you're generally not going to get that real deep sleep that your brain needs to rejuvenate, refresh yourself, and create those connections. So just to kind of wrap things up, try and sleep in a routine, try and sleep in the dark, and try and sleep in the cold. Those are three quick tips that should help you get a little bit better in sleep, which should help us all perform better in our MBA. If you do want to learn more, this book is excellent. It just came out. It's called Why We Sleep by Dr. Matthew Walker. If you're not a book reader, he was recently on the Joe Rubin Broken podcast.